Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of From the Field Q&A with P&J. My name is Pedro.
And I am John. Let's dive into some questions that we've had this past week. I will start off because I want to. So first question is there a feedback mechanism for content?
So yeah, yes, you are able to add comments and even at tag users on specific records, as you can see in this video.
Cool.
Next question, user, I'm not going to try to pronounce that, on GitHub asks, is it possible to query data from multiple databases? Ooh, this is a good one. And we hear this a lot, actually, so.
Yeah, so it was answered by Reich, but we do get this question a lot. By the way, Reich is always watching, so if you ever ask a question in GitHub or Discord, he's probably already on top of it. Mm-hmm. But the answer
Reich,
is...
CTO and co-founder.
True.
If you don't know.
Also guitar player extraordinary. Oof. So he does everything.
This is true.
But yeah, so currently the way that Directus is set up, it does connect to a single database. That is the way that it is currently done, but stay tuned. So a little teaser there for you. All right, Pedro, I think we have a list of a few questions that might have some simple answers. So let's kind of hit a couple of them real quickly.
Okay.
So the first question is, do you support GraphQL nested queries?
Yeah. Yes, we do.
Thumbs up
on that one.
Does your platform allow for reading, querying content via API?
Yes. Let's start the yes counter. That's two yeses.
Does your platform allow for writing, mutating content via API?
Ooh, do we have a three? Do we have a three? Yes, we have three yeses. That is a yes for that one.
And since we're on the API train, are your APIs and platform MACH compliant? So microservices, API first, composable, and headless.
Yep. That is the ding, ding, ding. You have a winner. All yes. Yes on that.
It's kind of convenient how all of those were yeses. I wonder how that was set up.
I wonder.
That's how we do it.
So next question, and this is our final question, I think. So what percentage of the functionality of your platform or of the app is available through the APIs? Is there any functionality only available through the UI that is not available from the API? And this is a question we get all the time and one of my favorites, but I'll let you answer it, John.
Yeah, I just like answering it because I'd rather have Jonathan, our sales engineer, come on and answer it. He gets very excited when he's talking about this.
Yeah.
Whenever you're interacting with the app, the data studio itself, all of that is driven by the API. So every single click, every data change, everything that you do in Directus is done via API. So It's very exciting. He gets very giddy when he's telling that. But yeah, everything that you can do in Directus is 100% API compatible. So you can use those things, you know, some aggregate, whatever you want to do via the APIs externally as well. So we are 100% API friendly.
Yeah. And if you think about the architecture behind Directus and what it is, it's like you have your database, Directus installed on top. And then on top of that, there's the no code app. So Directus being the APIs. So it's database, APIs, app built on top of those APIs. Very cool.
It's like an API sandwich, kind of.
API sandwich, yeah. I like that.
Sure.
Alrighty, thanks for watching. We hope you're keeping warm. Please like and subscribe to this YouTube channel and to this phenomenal Q&A with P&J that we do. And feel free to hop into one of our communities, GitHub, Discord. We live inside of Discord as a company, so if you want to come chat with John or myself, we are there. Probably 24/7 because we do not sleep.
Yeah.
So true. Always there to help answer your questions. And we hope you contribute to the community. And until next time, good night. Good night. Peace.
Good night. Good day, sir.
Good night. Good morning. Good evening. Good night. Wherever you are. Until next time. Goodbye.